Good morning, children. Welcome back to the social session. Children, we are going through the revision of formative assessment 1. The other day, we have gone with the first unit, reading and analysis of maps. So, under which we have learnt about the Babylonians, Sumerians preparing the clay tablets, age 2. The William Lambton, who was the first Survey General of India appointed in the British India. And even we have seen about James Rennell, who was the first Surveyor General, and William Lambton in 1802 started a mission measuring the height of the Mount Everest from the Chennai coast, and this was ended up by George Everest, who finished up measuring the highest peak of the world, that is Mount Everest. So because he measured it, so it was named after him. George Everest name was put to that peak as Mount Everest. And we also try to understand about the counter lines which are used in order to show the heights on the maps, and even there are many other patterns. Color patterns are there, dots pattern are there, different kinds of patterns are used in order to identify different kinds of features of a particular place in a map. Today, let us move on to energy from the sun. Under the energy from the sun, we have learned two important terms, children. One is radiation. Radiation, any body that emits out energy, okay, that any body which gives out energy is called as radiation, because sun is emitting continuously energy in the form of light and heat, we call it as a solar radiation, okay, we call it as solar radiation. Radiation means what? Radiation means any body that gives away energy is called as a radiation. And the second thing we have learnt is insolation, children. Insolation. Insolation means what? This is a short form of incoming solar radiation. Incoming solar radiation. It is a incoming solar radiation. So, after learning about the insolation and radiation, we came to an understanding that temperature distribution is not uniform all over the world. What are the reasons for the variation of this temperature from place to place and from the region to region? And in order to understand the distribution of temperature, we have taken four things as a category. First one is a latitude we have seen. Okay, this is a factor which influences the temperature. Second one is a water and land distribution. Water and land distribution. And third one is about the relief, the height we have taken into consideration. And fourth one is even the what we call the air circulation. Air circulation also causes a change in the temperature of a place. So what are these latitudes, water and land distribution, relief and the air circulation? You know, children, when the sun's rays fall almost obliquely at the equator, it is 90 degrees. So what happens here? The temperature will be high. At the equator, the temperature will be high. And as the latitude increases towards the north and towards the south, so this is 23, this is 66, this is 90, this is 23, this is 66, and this is 90. As the latitude increases, okay, the temperature decreases. At the poles, it will be minus degrees Celsius. At the poles, it is minus degrees Celsius. That means the sun's rays fall almost obliquely and it keeps on bending by the time it reaches to the pole. So very little sunlight is received at the poles. So it doesn't get hot there, it is completely cold in the poles, that is in the north pole as well as in the south pole. So latitude influences the distribution of a temperature on the earth's surface. Next one is about the water and land. Let us imagine this as a water and this as a land, children. You know it very well that land gets heated up more faster than the water. Land is a very good conductor of the heat than the water. See, when land gets heated up, it also cools down very fastly than the water. How it is proved? Now see, during the summer season, by 7 o'clock early, okay, it becomes so hot, and by evening 8 o'clock again, it gets cooled down. So it gets heated up very faster and it also cools down very faster. Now when I take the example of water, you jump during the summer season into a well or into a swimming pool. What do you feel? The upper layer will be little warm, but the lower layer will be cool. Am I right? And in the winter season, the upper layer will be cool and the lower layer of the water will be warm. So that means water gets heated up very lately than the land, and water also gets lately cooled down than the land. So because of this distribution, what happened? the places which are adjacent to the water and the places which are present interior records different temperature. That means there will be a variation of the temperature on the places which are adjacent to this water bodies and which are places located away from the water bodies. So this is how the water and land also helps in the distribution of the temperature. Third one is the relief. As you travel up from the sea level, the temperature decreases. It is at 6 degrees Celsius per every 1000 meters that temperature decreases. This is called as normal lapse rate, children. Normal lapse rate. So this is how the height also matters a lot from the sea level in order to understand the distribution of the temperature. This is what we have learnt in the energy from the sun. Remaining things we will see in the next class, children. Thank you.